What is up, guys? This is Lemillion Nation coming to you again with another video. Thank you for tuning in. Remember to hit that subscribe button, and we're reviewing the My Hero Academia manga 288. So, like, we have the raw scans and the spoilers, so if you guys don't want spoilers, please click on one of my other videos in the meantime until you're ready to come back to this one. Now, guys, I'm not sure how many of you guys are aware of this, but the My Hero Academia manga actually overtook One Piece.
NANI?! OMAE WA MOU SHINDEIRU.
Remember that One Piece was a reigning king for so many years like that. Not the anime itself, you know, at least from My Hero Academia, I mean. But My Hero Academia has overtook One Piece in manga sales. The volume of sales, the raw volume of sales for them has surpassed One Piece now. So it's rising in popularity. Like, One Piece anime is still, you know, One Piece is still overall the king, but just in manga sales, My Hero Academia has overtaken it. So, alright, guys, let's get into this chapter. This chapter does not start where it actually started, where it actually ended last chapter. We take a break from Deku and Shigaraki and everything. Like, remember that last chapter, Deku was like, he was falling onto the sky along with Shigaraki, and Deku was saying, hey, Shigaraki, don't move anymore, and like, just stay still. And Shigaraki, his master, was talking to him and telling him that he has like reached his limit, he should retreat for now to just heal up. Next time when he comes back at 100%, he will be able to take One For All. That's what his master was saying. So, guys, like, we're taking a break from all of that. We start with a plane, and that plane that's actually traveling has heroes in it. The heroes that are inside that plane, they're like talking. Like, we see Frappy this chapter as well. Like, Frappy, she's evacuating persons. We see all the heroes that we weren't seeing for such a long time, you know, all the heroes that we weren't seeing for a long time. We get to see them right now, and they're helping evacuating the injured, helping deal with all the destruction that the villains caused. Now over to the villains. Like, where we get off, we see that Toga Spinner was there with Mr. Compress. They were telling Toga to actually come back safely, come back unharmed. And you see Toga smiling, looking back at them like, they know what she's gonna do. They know what the plan that she has. She really wants to talk to Uraraka or Deku or so, and she's gonna go over to Deku after this as well too. I don't know how well or how bad that is gonna go, but let's see, you know. Alright, so we see Uraraka now. We flash over and we see Uraraka. Uraraka is helping person, and she's walking, like she's by herself walking. And then she hears a scream down the alleyway. So she runs towards that scream down the alleyway. She hears a scream from an old woman, and she runs down that alleyway to try to help, you know, heroes rush towards screams. So Uraraka went down there, and then out of nowhere we see Toga jump. And Uraraka is surprised, just as surprised as we were. Like, we saw Toga jump, and then Uraraka says, what? Toga? Like, we don't actually see the words, but it's like she says, oh, Toga, and then Toga sees her quickly, looks around quickly, like a quick look back, boom. And then she runs inside the building, and Uraraka rushes to follow her, because she's a known villain, so Uraraka runs to follow her, runs to try and to capture her. Uraraka runs inside the building to try to see what she can actually do right now to stop Toga. When she runs inside that building, of course, yeah, she's unarmed. She has her quirk and so, but she's unarmed. Toga is inside there, and like, Uraraka, when she actually goes in there, Toga actually starts talking to Uraraka, really, and they're talking and talking. They're having some form of dialogue. So now, when they're actually talking like that, we see Toga actually rush towards Uraraka, charge towards Uraraka with her knives, like, see, with her syringe-like things and her knives that she has. So what she does, she runs towards Uraraka and she tries to stab her. So Uraraka grabs her hand with her hand. She grabs her hand, like, we're not, see, Uraraka is not that weak shonen type woman like you see from Sakura, from Naruto itself back then, you know, or Lucy or so. Like, each one of them have their moments, you know, but Uraraka, she's been able to hold her own right from the get-go. But anyway, guys, after she catches her arm, like, we see Toga and Uraraka start talking. They're talking about heroes and, like, if the heroes actually see villains as humans, you know? Because Mr. Comfort, like, Mr., like, twice has just recently died. He just recently died, and Toga is like, she's in that stage of grief where she's wondering, why did I have to kill him, you know? She wanted to know the answer. Do they see villains as humans? Because the heroes are sworn to protect people. So did they not see twice as a person? Did they not see any of the villains as persons? She wants to know. You know, guys, yeah. So before that though, we see Gigantomachia actually rampaging. Roklak is seeing them, and you know that Roklak was over where the battlefield was. So Roklak sees Gigantomachia rampaging and causing so much destruction. So he's not asleep yet, and Roklak is actually seeing him. So that is really so that means probably more than likely next chapter we're gonna see where Gigantomachia actually goes towards Shigaraki, goes towards where the battle was, and try and probably save Shigaraki or so on. And I think we're gonna see Toga over there too. But anyway, let's get back to where we were. Like, she was so hurt after Twice's death, like she had to ask the questions to Uraraka and Deku. So we get a flashback this time to see Uraraka talking to Aizawa on a plane. Like, I don't know exactly what he was saying to her, but he was like probably teaching her some principles, and those principles she got to pass on here in this chapter. So what we see Uraraka actually do is shout something at Toga. Like, she shouts the answer back to Toga and tells her exactly how she feels, and tells her the answer to her question. Are villains humans or not? Why did they have to kill Twice? Uraraka got her answer, and when she got her answer, she was taken aback. She was visibly stopped. Her face was like paralyzed, and she was thinking about it. And that was basically where the chapter ended. Uraraka got into Toga's head. Like, she really told her the truth and convinced her of something. She let her know something so surprising that Toga had to stop. I remember they were in a struggle, fighting with each other. Like, Toga was trying to stab her and ask her the question at the same time, and Uraraka sternly gave her the answer. You know, guys, that's where she actually stopped what she was doing. Like, with Twice's death, it was so dramatic, and so it left a scar on most of the villains. It left a scar on her most of all. Like, she was really seriously hurt from all of that took place with Twice. She had to basically deal with it, and deal with it quickly, guys. Thank you so much for listening. Remember to like, subscribe. Thank you so much for tuning in. Remember to leave a comment below. Thank you. This is Lemillion Nation signing out. Oh, and stay tuned. Remember to actually like my other videos that are coming out of the reviews.